Hey everyone, today for episode number 3, we'll see how to control a WS2812B LED strip with a Sonoff Basic, ESP Home and Home Assistant. So for this project, you will need a Sonoff Basic, a 5V power supply, a WS2812B LED strip, and if it's the first time that you flash it, you will also need a serial adapter. You can find the link for everything below. First step will be to flash the Sonoff Basic. This is just like we did in the episode number 1, so you can refer to it if you need to. So let's just open the case. And now we only have to solder a 5-pin header right there to have access to the serial port to flash it and to the GPIO to control the LED strip. And now that we have the pin, we're ready to plug the serial adapter to the Sonoff Basic in order to be able to install ESP Home on it. So let's flash it. So as always, just plug the ground, RX, TX and the 3.3V to the Sonoff Basic. The pin near the push button is a 3.3V, then we have the RX, TX, ground and the GPIO14 that we'll use later. Okay, now it's time to flash it. So you just push the button and connect the serial adapter. Then release the push button and it should be in the programming mode. This time, instead of using my laptop to download and install the firmware on the Sonoff Basic, I will directly use the ESP Home add-on on Home Assistant. So my serial adapter is connected to my Raspberry Pi. I reboot the add-on to be sure that the serial port is detected. And now we can just press the plus, configure our node. On my side, it will be my kitchen light. We don't really care about the Wi-Fi that we input there, because on my side I'm using the secret and this is what is configured in the template. So like this. Now we can press edit and you copy the configuration that you can find in the link below. So let's take a look at the configuration. Here you have the name and the password of the Wi-Fi. On my side I put them in the secret in the add-on. There we have the push button, which is connected to the GPIO0. And here we have the LED strip. What I really like about using the Sonoff Basic is that you can use it to control the power supply. So you don't have to have the 5V power supply up 24/7. I've set the restart mode to always off, so we won't have any problem if we have a blackout. Here are the settings for the LED strip. So you have the pin, which is the GPIO14, you have the number of LEDs, and you have some other settings that you might add to tweaks if you have a different LED strip than me. And then there is the lighting effects. So there is a list on the ESP Home website, you can check what they have and you can build your own. And finally, we have the power supply. This one is connected to the relay of the Sonoff Basic, which is the GPIO12. Now let's just copy it right there. You can save it. And once saved, you can select your serial adapter and press upload. So now it should compile on your Raspberry Pi and upload it with the serial adapter. In the meantime, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel if you like this video. So now that it's uploaded, you should see it as online in the add-on. Now let's plug everything together. First step will be to plug the LED strip to the Sonoff Basic. What we want is to plug the green wire, which is data, and the white one, which is ground, to the Sonoff Basic. Of course, never plug the 3.3V of the Sonoff Basic to the 5V of the LED strip. So you can take normal jumpers like this. So just plug them together. Or you can also build your own plug if you have the right connector, just like this. Now it's time to put back the PCB in its case. In order to be able to connect it with the LED strip, we have to drill a hole at the top right there to pass the wires. Like this. Now just put the wire in it and then connect it to the headers that we had. So now we have the GPIO14 there and the ground just below. And now we can close the case. Next step is to connect the plug to the Sonoff Basic. Right there. Just add both wires there. Make sure that everything is clean and that they are not touching each other. and then you can put back the cover. Now that this is done, we can connect the power supply to the SANAF basic. So same thing than the other side. Make sure that everything is clean, nothing is switching the other wires. Once done, you can add back the cover again. Next thing is really important. Don't forget to ground your 5V power supply. So just connect the ground and you're done with it. Then you can connect the power supply with the SANAF basic. The last thing to connect is the LED strip, so just take the ground and the 5V, connect them to the power supply. You can connect the LED strip with the wire that we add to the SANAF basic. And that's it! Now everything should be fine. Now we can plug it. Once boot, the green light should start blinking. Just like this. Now let's go back to Home Assistant. So the node is still online. Let's just add the ESP Home integration for this node. So press add, look for the ESP Home integration, then write your node name like kitchenlight.local. And now let's see what it found. So we have our kitchen light, we have the state of the button and the light. Then on the light, we can see the color that we can choose, the brightness, and also the effects. Here's the result, so you can play with the colors, or like me, you can just connect your Home Assistant alarm with the different effects, so you can have a quick feedback. If you like this project, have a look at the other episode of this series, and don't forget to subscribe if you don't want to miss the next ones. Thanks!